हरि ओम स्टार्ट विद द प्रेयर। ओम समस्त जन कल्याणी निरतम करुणामयम नमामि चिन्मयम देवम सद्गुरुम ब्रह्म विद्वरम वसुदेव सुतम देवम कंसचानूर मर्दनम देवकी परमानंदम कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं त्वमेव माता च पितात्वमेव त्वमेव बंधुश्च सखात्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविडं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देव देव त्वमेव सर्वं गुरुदेव देव। हरि ओम। वी आर लुकिंग एट दी हू इज स्थित प्रज्ञः एंड द स्टेटमेंट एसेंशियली हू हैज अ समदर्शित्वम दैट कृष्णा मेंशन्ड इन दैट essentially the vidya vinaya sampanni brahmane gavihastini and sunischayva svabhagacha panditaha samadarshinah he has a equal vision whether it is a scholar or the samskara purusha or cow or a horse or an elephant and or a dog or a dog eater will have a panditaha the one who has a knowledge of that aham brahmasmi as samadarshinah so he is the one who doesn't krishna introduced in the very first shloka of the teaching where anosya anyasya sochatvam prajna vadam sabhasasi gata suna gata suncha nanu sochanti panditaha so panditaha nanu sochanti that they will not cry because these are all going and coming things so you don't cry for things that are continuously changing because he understood that I am the very substantive for the whole thing and whatever changing is only a vibhuti only. Now we'll address the karma aspect of it. We mentioned there are three aspects of karma. One is the sanchita karma, another prarabdha karma and the agami karma. Sanchita karma is the total vasanas that I have and prarabdha karma is that part of the total vasanas which are ready to germinate and which need to be experienced. So therefore prarabdha karma is dictates where I should be born and in what form, male, female or even in a plant form or an animal form or whatever the form that is conducive to exhaust those powerful vasanas that are ready to germinate at that time. And depending upon the vasanas, I need a proper body in order to exhaust those vasanas. If it is a human body, then I'll take a human body. If it is a divine body, I go to divine devalokas and exhaust. If it is an animal body, I take an animal body. So depending upon the vasanas that I had to take the body also, sula sariram. So therefore, the prarabdha karma are only that part of the total account, because total account is so big, only that part which is ready to germinate, ready to give actions which need to be experienced, and that which we call it a prarabdha, and that we brought into this world, and that's what is called prarabdha karma. And as a human being, I have a will to act, I am given a choice to perform. We mentioned that prarabdha karma is only the situation, provides the situation that I am in, but I have in that situation, I have a choice of action to do or not to do, to do another way. So that kartum sakyam, akartum sakyam, anyada akartum sakyam. So I have the shakti or the choice here, performing the action properly. What kind of choice I exercise, in fact I don't have choice but to choose a proper action. Not doing action is also a choice for me. Akartum sakyam is also a choice for me and I am accountable for that. So I have to do something. That's like nahi kachit chanamapi jatu tushasya karma kratu karyate havishak karma prakti jayganahi. So the Krishna says in the by propelled by the prakriti. Prakriti is nothing but my own vasanas or the prarabdha karma propel me to act in such a way because they cannot keep quiet even 1 minute. Nobody can keep quiet for a minute also. They have to continue to act, whether they have to breathing in or doing something, everything has to be going on. Life itself is nothing but action only. So the action is an expression of life. But while performing an action, for a human being there is a will will is coming into picture, I can will and a choice coming into picture, and therefore I can perform an action according to dharma or according to adharma, also violating the dharma. So when I perform an action, either dharma or adharma, results will come to me in some form. If it is a dharma, it will be punyam. If it is adharma, there will be papam. And I have to again experience the results of that. In therefore, future prarabdha is nothing but the past prarabdha modified by present action. So Gurudev said, so what I have is prarabdha, and what I do with what I have is purushartha. So human being has a purushartha and can be governed by dharma and artha, kama and moksha. These are essential purushartas glorified by the scriptures, provided I live in a disciplined way. And here, so prarabdha is what I bring in, where I am born, and in whether it is a male or a female, and all that depends upon the type of vasanas that I have. So to exhaust those vasanas, I am only being born, and to in the process of will, I can accumulate new vasanas by performing dharmic or adharmic, and vasanas are good or bad, and therefore they can be deposited into my account if it cannot be exhausted in this life. And that was called agami karma. Agami means the actions that are done in this life, now put into the account, which cannot be exhausted in this life, but have to be exhausted in future, in the next life or some other life, depending upon the nature of that karma. So called agami karma. So we have the total account, sanchita karma, prarabdha, what I brought it, agama is I put a new account, new deposit into the account. This will go on until the whole vasanas are exhausted. Vasanas will not get exhausted because I am putting more into the account itself. So this goes on, that's why the action, this is becoming continuously. Only the actions that are meritorious actions will lead me somehow to punya lokas and propel me to think properly, and therefore a manushya janma is given, and manushya janma where I can have an analysis of my life and then redirect, in spite of prarabdha, redirect my life towards the higher, towards the understanding of what is nature behind nature of this. So that's how I become a jivan muktaha. So now what happens to all these karmas? That this is what being addressed now in the sloka 449 of the Vivek Chudamani. Aham brahmeti vijnanat, aham brahmeti vijnanat, kalpakoti satarjitam, kalpakoti satarjitam, sanchitam vilayam yati, sanchitam vilayam yati, prabodha swapna karmavat, prabodha swapna karmavat. So aham brahma iti vijnanam kalpakoti satarjitam. This I am is that recognition that I am Brahman is a result of the many, this is kalpa koti satarjitam. The koti, this is a benefit earned because of thousands of my previous lives. Whatever the punyam that I have accumulated, I am led into this situation where because of my punyam only, I was exposed to a proper teacher and proper guru. And this is what essentially called Ishvara Prasadam also. So to get a teacher itself is to have a desire to understand the truth, jignyasu, is itself is a benefit, that is dullabham, is being born as a human being and desire to evolve, that is called mumukshutvam. And once I have desire, having a appropriate teacher for that is also a blessing indeed. And daiva anugraha hetukam, it says daiva anugraham only by the blessing of the Lord. But Lord blesses everybody equally. Samoham sarvabhuteshu. So how can he favor somebody and not favor somebody? Therefore, daivanugraham really means essentially, he says, the kalpakoti satarjitam punyam only expressed as daiva, the God's grace, because it's adrushtam. Adrushtam means I cannot see exactly what it is, and it is अहम ब्रह्मेति विज्ञानात् कल्पकोटि सदार्जितम्. इट इज द लाइफ ऑफ मेनी मेनी लाइफ. So Krishna himself says, "Bahunam janma janmanam ante gyanavanmam prapajyate vasudevasaramiti sabahatma sudullabha." So bahunam janmanam ante, after lives of many many lives only people recognize this, the truth about myself or truth about themselves. Bahunam janmanam ante vasudeva. Vasudeva is Brahman. Says that which the existence everywhere, as the deva is the consciousness, and vasu is that vasati, that which exists and supports the whole thing. So it is such chit ananda is what is essentially glorified as vasudeva. Vasudeva is not the vasudeva son, that's also vasudeva also, but here vasudeva sarvamiti, everything is nothing but vasudeva, everything is nothing but satchidananda, and satchidananda nothing but aham brahmasmi, and that knowledge can only come bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate. Mam prapadyate, mam is that vasudeva, that is aham brahmasmi is prapadyate. And samatma sudurlabha, that kind of mahatma is very rare indeed. So the number of people who can go up to that stage is very rare, because it's a pyramidal structure where bahunam the manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid yatate siddhaye yatadapi siddhanam kaschin mam vittatvatah. So thousands of people, only few people are really interested in Vedanta. That's why there is not many people attend Vedanta class. If it's a bhajan class, some more people will attend, or if it's a Bhagavata class, there is stories, because they still want a stories type. But understanding the truth behind, where one has to use nitya anitya vastu viveka, understanding the nature of the reality, that I had to use the subtle intellect, and that not many people are really interested in that. So there is a hierarchy of that in terms of how many really interested. And therefore bahunam janmanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samatma sudurlabha. Sudurlabha means very difficult indeed. Dullabha is difficult, sudurlabha means indeed very difficult. That's what Krishna says. And here is same statement in aham brahmeti vijnanat kalpakoti satarjitam. That's the first line. Sanjitam vilayam yati prabodha swapna karvavatu. Now he is addressing about the sanchita karma. Sanchita karma is maybe heaps and heaps of karma is there in my account. What happens to that karma? Sanchitam vilayam yanti, it gets destroyed. Prabodha swapna karmavatu. When I get up from the sleep, from the dream, when I get up into the waking state, all my actions and punyam, papam, all that I have done in the dream, it gets exhausted immediately. I am free from all that. So just because I have a millionaire in that punyam there, I have got millionaires in my dream state, and I cannot cash it in the waking state, all that has no meaning. I may be a murderer in the dream state or do all sorts of things in the dream state, but I cannot be arrested in the waking state, because in the dream you killed somebody. So therefore this is sanchitam vilayam yati prabodhat swapna karmavatu. Prabodhat, when I am getting awake from the swapna, all actions done in the swapna, in the dream world, has no meaning in the waking state itself. All that sanchitam is also because it is like a swapna. Swapna means I have a notion that I am a body, mind, intellect due to ajnanam. Therefore I am performing an action. Therefore I am having kartrutva bhava and bhoktutva bhava. I am a doer and enjoyer, and therefore the accounts belong to me. Therefore the sanchita karma belongs to the one who has the notion that I am a doer. That's the essence, isn't it? There is a kartrutva bhavam is involved, and as long as kartrutva bhavam is there, bhoktutva bhavam is also has to come, because when I perform an action with an attitude that I am a doer, then I have to bear the consequence of that doing. Therefore I have to be born in an environment that is to be, I may escape the local laws. So you can pay proper amount and proper bribes, including bribing judges also. You may escape the law here and say, I am free. You can never be free from the action that you have done. You may escape local law, that's also maybe part of prarabdha, but you will suffer the consequence of the actions. The question that is, says, when does the prarabdha come ends and when does the purushartha comes? What I have is prarabdha, what I do now with what I have. What I have is the result of the past. So environment that I am in the society that I am born, with the family that I have, whether it's a wife, child, boy, husband, or whatever the environment, is due to prarabdha. Now what I do with what I have is purushartha. So depending upon the laws of society and all that, I continue the commitment that I have made in the family, continue, but with the vision of higher. So if I have the inclination to know Vedanta, and in spite of the family circumstances, it becomes a lot responsibility to get for you to get an opportunity to learn or to do Vedanta, Shravanam, Shrotavyaha, Mantavyaha, if I have this strong desire for Mumukshutvam. And Lord will fulfill the desire in some form or other, in one way or other, providing you an opportunity. But when the opportunity comes, I have to make use of the opportunity in such a way that Lord has given the opportunity, and that is what is my prarabdha also, because of my punya palam. Prarabdha can be punyam and also papam also. It will be merits or demerits also. That's what prarabdha. And purushartha is my activity in the present, and therefore all that previous actions that are done because of the notion that I am a doer will not have any meaning. How can that be disappear? So by knowing that, because now I know that I am akarta and abhokta. I am never a doer. Not only now, in the past also I am not a doer. Prakriti was doing, and unnecessarily I was keeping thinking that I am doing it. It's only wrong notions in the mind, but the Prakriti itself is doing. In the past also Prakriti only did, in the present also it is going, and even the future also Prakriti will be doing only. But I take the role of a Prakriti and take ownership. That ownership is called Ahankara, because I am this. I am this body which is doing the function. You know who did this? I did it. And therefore that's what is Ahankara. Ahankara is claiming something that what Prakriti has done as I have done it, and therefore I have to bear the consequence. If I realize that I am never a doer, even now also when the doing is going on, and therefore I am liberated completely from all the past itself. There's a story, statement from where I read is that what happens to the past good and bad. So when the Mahatma's account, because accounts are so clear, so when the account is done, so it doesn't belong to him. And now what happens to his punya and papa? Those, remember, we just now said in the previous sloka, says the one who has some people sadhu nam, they pray him, whereas gurjanaha, they abuse him. So who gets punyam and who gets papam? Sadhu people will get the punyam of that. Punyam means what? The benefit of his knowledge, because that's all they are looking for. They don't want again some merits and all that. So benefits of his teaching comes as the punyam of that only. And those, that means they will be blessed. People who have said, please bless me, please bless me. The teacher is going to bless them by teaching only. Every other blessing has no meaning, and it's only satisfaction of the mind only. The blessing that I want is, I want the teaching itself and form abidance in the teaching so that I have no more doubts. That is the punyam that will be coming to the disciples from the teacher. And the papam, that when the Gurjanaha commit and abuse even that Mahatma, his papam will go to them only, because they are seeing only papam only everywhere, and hurting a Mahatma is a double papam also, and all that means his papam is going there. And therefore papam punyam is depending upon the, that's why you have to be careful. We don't know who is a realized person or who is not a realized person. Therefore, treat all Mahatmas equally, because Samadarshanam has to be there. Lord is there and he is doing a good job. If you don't like it, just move away from them. The other people are getting benefit out of that, and let them continue. So there should not be any abuse or criticism of other Mahatmas also, because you get their papam only. And therefore, it says, Sanchitam Vilayam Yati Prabodha Swapna Karmavatu. Sloka in the Chandrasekhar Bharati gives a simple sloka here. Yatkrutam Swapna Melayam Punyamba Papam Ulbanam Sapto Supto Stitasyakim Satsat Swarga Yanarakayava. So Swapna Melaya. So in the Swapna Mela, in the dream state, yat ulbanam, that intense papam va punyam va krutam, the papam and punyam that I have done intensely in my dream, when I am in the dream, and tat suptostitasya swargaya narakaya vasyat, and it may be the swargam and narakam I may have to go through in the dream only, but have nothing to do when I am awakened to the state, and that doesn't belong to me. Those do not leave any vasanas. In fact, dreams only exhaustive mechanism of vasanas only. And because why? Asangoham, 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 punah punaha. Sachidananda rupoham, ahamevaham avya. I am unattached from the body level, from the mind level, from the intellect level. I am pure, all pervading. There cannot be attachment to me. And that infinite cannot be attached to anything. Because it's infinite. Because there cannot be anything other than infinite for it to get attached. So asangoham, 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 punah punaha, sachidananda rupoham, ahamevaham avyaha. This is by the Brahmavali, by the Shankaracharya. So we'll continue about this prarabdha karma and the karma aspect in the next talk. We'll stop here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.